Oh, bro, I'm so sorry. Bro, hang on one second.
$8 Canadian on the floor.
Oh, and then he stepped on
it. I almost slipped. Bro, I dropped all your hot dogs, bro. I am so sorry. Here you go.
Yeah, right.
Alberta pork.
Oh, wow.
Hey, he is just like that guy. Yeah. He's Canadian.
You see? I'm just your average guy.
Yeah.
I am normal, and there's nothing wrong with me.
Undisputed champion, the WWE Undisputed Champion, The Undertaker.
Red Devil, Big Evil.
Well, that shirt pretty well tells the story.
That was Tommy Dreamer. I think I'd be joining that guy. Got the crowd there and eat the rest of those hot dogs from ringside. Why is Tommy Dreamer not leaving?
I don't know. I don't know why the Undertaker's even coming out here.
Watch that mustard off your face. Make yourself presentable, Tommy Dreamer.
Apparently, the Undertaker's got something to say.
Yeah.
I don't know about this situation.
Dreamer will have some hair for dessert and wash it down with toilet water. Dreamer's in Undertaker's yard right now.
So you're just a normal, average guy. Well, Mr. Normal, Average Guy, I am the WWE Undisputed Champion. And you're now on my time. So, if I may make a suggestion to you, I suggest you hit the bricks before I kick your ass.
Right. See RVD last week, JR.
Might be a good idea.
I was just out here trying to tell the people what.
What part of you're on my time did you not understand?
Yeah. See ya.
Even Hulk Hogan. Who I retired.
What?
Uh-oh.
Didn't take up my time. Last Monday night on Raw, RVD, who I beat without any trouble at all.
Oh, come on.
Did not take up any of my time.
That's true.
So tell me, Tommy Dreamer, what makes some sideshow circus freak think he can stand in the middle of my yard and take up my time?
Stuck for an answer on that one, aren't you, freak? Tommy.
In other words, get the hell out of here!
Right! Eat it!
Fine, bro. Fine.
Whoa, Dreamer.
Uh-oh.
I tell you what, since you're already out here, I'm here. What do you say? How would you like a shot at the title?
What?
What?
Oh, look at Dreamer.
What is right?
Look at that
smile. I would love a shot at your title.
You'd like a shot?
Yeah, me and you.
Yeah, I bet you would, but you're not going to get one.
I just said I could have one.
You know why? Because you're not worthy. Now, before you get a long, sad face, let me just tell you, there's a dressing room full of wrestlers back there, and they're not worthy either.
Have you seen who's back there?
Yeah, I know everybody's back there. And there ain't a person in that dressing room that poses a challenge to me.
Wow. I doubt that very much, quite frankly. Who's he trying to convince, himself or?
But because I am a nice guy, and you love to entertain the people, right?
I do.
And you like to entertain the people by doing disgusting things.
Oh, no.
I don't think they're disgusting, but okay.
Well, I got one for you.
You're just a normal guy, huh? What's this going to be, JR? Uh-oh. That ain't what I think it is it?
Now I want you to entertain me and these people.
No.
So, you're gonna drink my tobacco spit.
Oh no!
Oh God almighty.
I can't do that. I can't do that.
You gotta draw the line somewhere.
Exactly.
No. I think you misunderstood what I was saying. I'm not asking you, I'm telling you.
But that's really, really gross, man. That's gross.
Worse than toilet water.
Okay. Let me put it another way. Maybe this you'll understand. Either you drink this spit, or you'll be taking the rest of your meals for the rest of your life through a tube.
It's tobacco spit. Yeah, but a tube, JR.
Oh, God, I
can't watch it.
Whoa.
Thanks, I knew you were only kidding, man. That's cool.
That might have been just a little stiff. Here, let me help you out, give it just a little more flavor.
Undertaker, I'm about to lose my lunch. This is disgusting. He's bullying this man as the Undertaker.
Now, drink it.
What a nasty habit. What a nasty habit. You gotta drink it. I can't watch this, JR. I got a weak stomach.
Undertaker's gonna make this poor human being drink that spit, that tobacco juice spit. Or he's gonna beat the hell out of Tommy Dreamer. Oh, God. This is some champion. I can't believe this. I don't think the
that was
either.
Pretty good. What he is this, it. Man? Thanks, bro.
He liked it. Oh, and the Undertaker with the right hand. Dreamer drank the damn tobacco juice.
That's the thanks you get.
And then gets sucker punched.
Well, he's a circus sideshow freak. Don't hit him in the stomach, whatever you do. That stuff might reappear.
Man, what a shot that was. Dreamer taking the turnbuckles by the WWE Undisputed Champion, who's actually nothing more than a schoolyard bully here.
Look out, here comes the tobacco pit up again.
I mean, King, what kind of a champion is The Undertaker? To make another, to humiliate another human being.
You're giving the guy every chance in the world to leave. Reaper, stay down here.
Ooh. I just don't understand this whatsoever.
You don't want to drink some spit, do you?
Hell no, I don't. Tommy Dreamer, no other human being alive deserves this.
He might not be drinking anything.
The same thing that The Undertaker, well, I thought he was going to do the same thing he did the Hollywood Hulk Hogan at Judgment Day. Oh, no, it's even worse. Look at this. Dreamer, no! That steel chair right around the neck of Tommy Dreamer. Sit right to the steel post.
What's worse, Tommy?
How can people cheer The Undertaker is beyond me when Tommy Dreamer's neck may be broken.
I don't hear anybody cheering The Undertaker.
Now, my friend, that's disgusting.
Yeah.
I'll second that. Yeah. Boy, that's a WWE champion we all look up to and be proud of, okay?
He don't ask you to look up to him or be proud of him. He just asks you to respect him and fear him.
Absolutely sick.
What would you have done?